Hello everyone. In this session, we'll discuss about a simple Java program. So here you can see a simple Java program. In this, the first line is my first Java program is what it is a comment. Means what? Compiler does not execute this part. It's a comment. It is just for programmer to understand what this program is all about. Okay. So here we have slash star and star slash. So this is multi-line comment. Why? Because slash star and my you can write on one line, first on second line, yes, my first Java on second line, and program on third line, like this, and end it star slash. Okay, so three lines, right? So you can write the description on multiple lines. So that is why we call it as multi-line comment. You don't have to use slash star each and every line. Okay, so that is why we call it as multi-line. And we have one more comment part, that is single line comment. Single line comment means what? You have to write my first Java program on a single line. You cannot split it. Okay, just like what we did for multi-line comment. First, my first Java program on single line. Okay, so that is what about so that is a single line comment. So slash star is what? Slash star, star slash is multi-line comment, and double slash is single line comment. And here we have a class. Class is a keyword, and first prog, this is what? Class name. Okay, and class name and file name should be same. So what is the file name? Firstprog.java, and class name is firstprog. So you had to use the curly braces for class, that is curly brackets, right? This is starting and this is ending point. Okay, so and here we have a main method, execution. Please remember, execution of Java program always starts from main function. Okay, so here main function or main method is of which type? Public, static, void type. So public, we have different specifiers, modifiers, that is access modifiers or access specifiers. Here we have used public, and main should always be public. Main method should always be of public type. Okay, so you cannot give any other access mode. And we have different modes also. We have different access specifiers or access modifiers, that is private, public, and protected, default. Default means if you don't use any anything there. For example, if I just use static, void, main, then by default it is the default access specifiers. Okay, if you use public keyword, then it is a public. If you use private, it's a private. Then if you use protected, then it will be protected. Okay, so main method, please remember, main method should always be, must be of which type? Public type. And static, it should be static and void. Return type should be void. It should not return any data type. Okay, it should not return any value. That is why it's a void type. And string arguments means what? Since we'll be passing some arguments. Say for example, we are passing input here. What is the input? This is my first Java program. So we are passing some value, what is that, string or integer value, whatever, right? So then we are trying to display it on the screen. That is why it should be what? Arguments. You had to write a string args means what? We are trying to pass some value. Strings means what? You can pass, can be integer value, it can be of what, string, whatever. So it should be, you had to use string args here. Okay, since we are trying to display some message, that is what, this is my first Java program, this is the final output, right? And we are using println here. It is a system.out.println. It just works like printf in C. Okay, and what is that printf, what is the use of printf there? It will print some message on the screen, right? It will print some message on the screen. And what about C++? We have used C out, right? C out, it is C out printf, just like C out in C++ and printf in C. Here we are using in Java, we have system.out.println to print some message on the console window or on the command prompt. Okay, so println is a method, and what about the system.out? We'll discuss it later. So as of now, just remember system.out.println is used to print the message on the console window or command prompt. So next, here, as I said, any Java program can be written using simple text editors like Notepad, Notepad++, or WordPad. You can install Notepad will be by default. Notepad and WordPad will be available to you. And if you want, your program to look better, then you can go for Notepad++. Okay, so better you can go for Notepad, and then. So here, just open Notepad and make sure that go to D drive. Okay, go to D drive, right click and select new, and then select Notepad. Okay, so open Notepad there and type this program. Type this program, and after typing the program, please save the program. How to save? Go to File, Save As. Go to D drive again. Save As D drive. You have to save your file. Save As. What is the class name here? Class name is first prog, right? First prog. So save it as first prog dot java. Okay, first prog dot java. And then note that the name, third point, see the third point, note that the name of the program is first prog and class name is first prog. As I said, class name and file name should be same. And remember, I'll repeat it once again, class name, which class name? Main class. Main class means what? So here you can see this in this program, first prog is what? A main class. First prog is main class because this contains main method. So wherever you see main method, then that particular class, if a class contains main method, then that particular class is what? Main class. So here first prog is main class. Done. And then, so note that the name of the program is first prog and class name is first prog. The extension to the file name should be .java. Therefore, we have saved our first program by the name first prog.java. Yes, the output of this program can be generated on the command prompt using commands. So here we have two commands. One is Java C and the other one is Java, right? So Java C, if you see this one, Java C is what? It is used to compile. Means what? Compile means convert source program to source program is what? Whatever the program you have typed is what? Source program. That's high level language that user can understand. So you need to convert it from source code to machine code that processor can understand. Okay, so Java C, to convert that source code to machine code, we use Java C, that is compiler converts it. Yes, first prog dot java, here you have to use extension. So that is why dot java is used here. You must use dot java extension. Okay, so for second command, Java first prog, you don't have to use extension, but by default that extension is what? Dot class. So but you don't have to use dot class explicitly. Compiler will automatically take it. By the time you use Java, it will automatically assume that this is dot class. If dot class is not present, it will throw some message, it will display some error message. Okay, so make sure to use Java C first and then go for Java. So Java, so as I already explained you in the previous videos, in order to run Java, use Java C command, you should have JDK in your system. In order to use Java command, you should have JRE as well as JVM in your system. Okay, and then use these two commands, Java C first prog dot java and Java space first prog. That's it. Okay, you can even use Java space first prog dot class also, it's fine. Yes, next. So here we have simple steps you just open command prompt and go to D drive. I already explained how to go to D drive in the previous video. So first go to D drive. In that D drive, please type these commands, Java C space first prog dot java, Java space first prog, and the final output is what? This is my first Java program, that is the output. Okay, and then so in our first Java program, on the first line we have written a comment statement as my first Java program. This is multi-line comment, already told you, right? And then second one is what? Double slash my first Java program, that is what? This is a single line comment. Done. And here class first proc. Class is a keyword and first proc is what? It's a variable name. It's a user defined name. Here I've used first proc. You can use, you can give your own name, first program or program demo program, like that. You can give your own name. Okay. But class is a keyword. You cannot change class, and it is a case sensitive. You cannot. So first letter of class should be C. Okay. And so because I've seen many students using capital C, don't do that. It's a case sensitive. Java program is a case sensitive. Please, very important. Java program is a case sensitive. First proc is a variable name of class. Note that name of the class and name of your Java program should be same. As already told, yes, it should be same. Class name and file name should be same. The class definition should be within the curly brackets. Yes. So the class definition should be within the curly brackets. Public static void main. This line is for a function void main. The main, so that's not mean. The main is of type public static void. Yes, the public is an access mode of the main, right? Access or access means or access modifiers or access specifiers. So it should be, it must be, typically main must be declared as public. So make a note, tip, main must be declared as public. You cannot declare it as private or protected or default also. Okay, the parameter which is passed to main is string args. Here string is a class name. String is a class name. Okay, it's not primitive data type. Here yes, capital, right? S is capital. It's not primitive data type. So string is a class name and args is an array which receives the command line arguments when the program runs. So that is why, you know, if you want to display some message on the screen, you have to use arguments. You have to pass some arguments. That is what your we don't have any array or elements in the array, but empty array. Even if you have empty array, it's fine, no problem. Args is an array which receives command line arguments when the program runs. Done. And then simple program. Okay, here system.out.println. This is my first Java program. This is what the how exactly it works. Very important part. To print any message on the console, println is a method in which the string, this is my first Java program, is written. After println method, the new line is invoked. So here, see this one. This is what ln. We have ln here. Ln means what? New line. After printing this particular string, this is what string. Since it is inside double quotes, whatever you write inside double quote is what? It will consider it as string. Okay. So this is my first Java program is a string now. It is inside double quotes, right? So after printing this message on console window or command prompt, it will go to, cursor will go to new line. That is why we are using ln, print ln here. Okay, so that so after print ln method, new line is invoked. Okay, and then system.out. System is a predefined, so obviously it will take some time for you to understand what exactly system.out, why have we used system.out. Okay, I'll just try to explain in a better way so that you will understand. Okay, so the system is a predefined class. So why is it class? Because the first letter of system is what? It is in capital letter. So system, it's a class, predefined class. Yes, predefined class. Okay, that is inbuilt class. Out is an instance of system class. Please make a note, out is an instance of system class. Here out is an output stream which is related to console. In order to print some message on the screen, you must use out here. Okay, so in order to access out, okay, make use of system. So obviously out is what? It is static method. Why is it static class? It's a static class. I'll tell you why it is class. Though the first letter of out is in small letter, it is a class. Why is it class? I'll tell you now. Okay, so here is a static class. Okay, so how do you access static method? Yeah, okay, obviously it's out is a static method. Okay, fine. How do you access static method? Using class, by directly using class, that is system class. So system dot out, and println is present in out method. Okay, so next, here now you'll understand it better. So now you can see this. I told you out, though the first letter of out is what? It is in small letter. It is a class, but So why it is class? Because we are here, we have print stream. Print stream, print, first letter of print stream is what? It is in capital letter, that is P is in caps, right? So now this entire package is taken as out. Okay, it is considered as out. So now it becomes method, right? So now which it, this out is of which type? Static type. So how do you access static methods? I told you many times, to access static members you should use class name directly. Okay, in order to access, what is the class name? Static is what? Static is the class name, correct? System is the class name, system class. So in order to access static methods, use class name directly, system dot out. You don't have to create the object, correct? But so now out is, this print is print function is present inside which which method? Out method. So in order to access non-static member, that is a print method, okay, print method, you have to use system dot out print. Okay, so this is how you can access print method, which is present inside out method. And out method is what? A print stream is actually a class, so convert it to method. You cannot call it as out method also. So for your understanding purpose, I'm considering it as method. Okay, so system dot out dot print. Hope you understood now. Why I'll just repeat it once again in simple words. Print is what? Print is present inside out class, okay, and out method. Yes, and print stream is what? Out is of which type? Out is of print stream type. Okay, out is of print stream type. And out is instance of, out is an instance of system class. Yes, so in and out is present in which class? System class. So since out is static, how do you access it? Using class name. So system dot out. So in order to access print, use system dot out dot print or println. Ln is what? New line, that's it. Okay, you can use either print or println, it's up to you. So hope you understood this very important part. And next we'll move on to, okay, last part. Java is a case sensitive programming like C or C++. Okay, it's a case sensitive. As I said, class C, if I have a class is a keyword, right? You can, first letter of C, class, first letter of class is what? C. It should be in small letter. You cannot write it in upper letter, right? That uppercase letter. So please be very careful. It is a case sensitive. Okay. Hope you have understood. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any doubts, please comment below. Like, share, and comment. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel for more updates. Thank you so much. Mm-hmm.